Overnight news, the first American has died from the mysterious coronavirus. The U.S. Embassy confirming to NBC News a 60-year-old who'd contracted the virus in Wuhan died Thursday. And this morning, growing fears the virus may be spreading here at home. According to the CDC, at Travis Air Force Base near San Francisco, five evacuees rescued from the epicenter earlier this week have been rushed to local hospitals after showing symptoms.
We're being very aggressive, using quarantine measures that haven't been used in 50 years.
Friday, three more planes full of evacuees from Wuhan landed at military bases in San Diego, San Antonio, and Omaha. Across the country, hundreds of Americans remain in quarantine. American Yulin Yin's one of them. He arrived Wednesday, still in good spirits, despite being stuck for 2 weeks at a military base in San Diego.
The weather is great, better than Minnesota, where I came from. So I don't have complaint.
Yin Lin says he's showing no symptoms, but officials are taking no chances. There's much we still don't know about the virus.
That includes exactly how it spreads, how deadly it is, whether it's commonly transmitted by patients who are not yet displaying symptoms, and other issues.
Questions causing trouble at sea. South of Tokyo, a dream holiday turned nightmare. Aboard the Diamond Princess, more than 60 confirmed cases, including at least a dozen Americans. In total, more than 3,700 passengers and crew either quarantined on the ship or hospitalized. Another cruise liner quarantined off the coast of Hong Kong. And in Newark, New Jersey, four Chinese nationals escorted off a Royal Caribbean cruise, some on stretchers, even though they showed no symptoms of the virus.